Hello Subhra, so today we are going to discuss about the protein binding. As I have already discussed you with the protein binding, see according to protein binding we have discussed two types of protein binding, that drug can become protein bound in the body with two types of proteins. One is which is present in your bloodstream, that is the plasma proteins. Example, we discussed about HSA and AAG. Okay, and then the drug can become bound to the extravascular tissues, the fats, the bones, like the adipose tissue. Now, the binding which happens to the plasma proteins is reversible in nature, and it is generally not very toxic in nature. It is reversible and it gets slowly eliminated out from the body. Okay, but the protein binding that occurs with the extravascular tissues is generally irreversible in nature, occurs by the help of strong covalent bonds, and it might lead to severe toxic reactions. Now, all these things have already been discussed. What are the factors that affect protein binding? How the volume of distribution increases? The basic clinical significance of protein binding, as I told you, was that what happens when the drug gets protein bound is that the elimination half-life increases. Okay, the drug becomes inactive pharmacologically, it becomes inert pharmacodynamically and pharmacokinetically. That is, it is neither metabolized, it is neither excreted out from the body. Now, if we discuss the kinetics of protein binding, now considering P, if it is visible to all of you, considering P to be the concentration of protein and D the concentration of the drug. Okay, so now let me consider, if I say P plus D gives you a complex, that is PD. Okay, now applying the law of mass action, applying the law of mass action for the forward reaction, okay, for the forward reaction I get KA is equal to PD, concentration of PD divided by concentration of protein and the concentration of drug. Now what is this KA? This KA represents the association rate constant for the forward reaction. Now from this equation, what I can do is, I can get as the value of PD will be equal to, the complex PD can be written as KA P into T. I am simply cross multiplying these terms. So considering this to be equation 1, suppose, so the value of complex PD becomes KA multiplied by P into D. Now, let's decode these values once again. What is the complex PD? This is the concentration of the protein drug complex. What is KA? Association rate constant. What is P? Concentration of the free protein. What is D? It is the concentration of the free drug. Okay, now considering the total amount of the total concentration of protein in the body, let us assume that the total amount of protein in the body is PT. So what will be the value of PT? Will be, it is equal to P plus PD. That is, this is unbound protein and this is the bound protein. Okay, now let us introduce a new term as small r. What is r? R represents, small r represents, just pay attention to this, represents the number of moles of the drug that is bound to the total number of protein present in the body. This is the number of moles of the drug that is bound to the protein, to the total amount of protein. That is, R is equal to PD, that is the amount of drug that is bound to the protein, to the total protein present in the body. So we can write this as PD upon, what is PT? P plus PD. Okay, I hope this is clear to you so far. Now, if I substitute the value of PD, in this equation from equation 1. Okay, remember I am substituting this value of PD over here. Okay, so what will I get? I am continuing the equation, the derivation over here. So what is the value of PD? I can write it as R is equal to KA P into D upon, what do I over, P plus again P into D. So just check it once again carefully. What I have done over here is, I have substituted the value of PD from equation 1. Okay, now in this entire expression, consider this to be equation 2. What is common? If you see, the term P is common. Okay, so taking P as common and cancelling it out, what do we get? We get R is equal to KA D upon 1 plus Ka into D. Now this is almost your final expression. Now considering the number of binding sites to be capital N, considering the number of binding sites to be capital N in the body, this is the number of binding sites. Why we are taking this term? Because in our body the number of binding sites is going to be limited. See, this is a saturable process. It is going to be limited by the number of binding sites that are available for protein binding. So we can represent this, or we can modify this equation as, we will get R is equal to capital N Ka D upon 1 plus Ka into again D. So this is your final expression for, this is the final expression for the kinetics of protein binding, which gives you R. What is R? R is the number of moles of drug that is bound. See, what we are trying to find out by the kinetics of protein binding is the number of moles of the drug that becomes bound after administration. So the number of moles that of the drug that becomes bound can be determined by this formula, that is N Ka D 1 plus Ka into D. I'm sure now you can memorize what are the meaning of these terms. Again, I will try to tell you Ka, what is Ka? Ka was the association rate constant. Okay, it is a constant. It is constant for all drugs. Now, the question is that how can you determine the value of Ka? Okay, now the value of Ka can be determined only by graphical method. Okay, we can determine this value by graph, by a graphical method, by a semi-logarithmic graphical method. So what are those graphical methods? Those graphical methods, we have four methods, and the methods are, first is direct method, second we have a Hitchcock graph method, third we have a Clotz method, and one is the Stuttgart plot method. Okay, so there are four types of graphs in which what we do is we take the value of R, say for example on the y-axis, the value of D on the y-axis. Okay, in a second type we plot log scales, then in the third we take reciprocal scales, and in the fourth we take double reciprocal scales. Those graphs will be discussed by me in another video, or I will discuss them in the class. Okay, so till then what you have to do is you have to remember this derivation. This is a very short derivation of protein binding. What happens in protein binding is that we have the concentration of protein and the drug which get bound and they form a complex PD. This process is governed by a rate constant, and that is Ka, that is the association rate constant. At equilibrium we apply the law of mass action, and this law of mass action gives us this equation that Ka is equal to PD upon P into D, that is the concentration of products upon the concentration of reactants. Finally, we come to the total amount of proteins, and ultimately we have to find the value of R, which you determine by this formula. Okay, so this derivation is very important. Why it is important? Because this derivation is useful in enzyme catalysis also. This derivation you will be also studying in upcoming units as nonlinear pharmacokinetics. It is similar to Michaelis-Menten equation also. So right now you have to remember about what is the number of moles, how do we determine the kinetics of protein binding, what is the significance of R, what is the significance of D, what is the significance of Ka. Okay class, so in the next video I will discuss with you about the various graphical methods, how we determine Ka, what is the clinical significance of protein binding. Till then, keep on revising. We shall meet in the next video. Thank you.